Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Nominee, the ministry you are just about to take over, if this committee and the House approves you, is one of the key ministries in the country, akin to roads, water, and every Kenyan is looking upon you to be connected to electricity. And there are not two options to it. Even before I ask you the question, it's good to know that there are historical injustices in terms of power supply in the country, such that, take the case of the year 2017, Tharaka constituency was at 9.5% connectivity to the national grid. At the same time, Gatundu South constituency was at 100%. These are all equal Kenyans. There really should not be that disparity. Number two, we have schools. Schools where electricity is just but mandatory. Yet, those areas are not connected to the national grid, and the children are supposed to compete competitively in national exams, which are standard. My question to you is, would you be subscribing to a form of affirmative action in terms of electricity supply to constituencies which have lagged behind? And it's just not Tharaka. You go to Mwingi North, you go to Mbalambala, which is also my neighbor, Bere North, Bere South. These actually have been discriminated against. And therefore, would you be prepared to take affirmative action in respect of those constituencies?
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To Honorable Opio Wandai, the nominee. My colleagues have talked about electricity. You have talked about the transformers. Do you see we need to move away from oil-based transformers, because every other day you will hear people removing the oil from the transformers, and we have got transformers which do not work sometimes, or we have got a shortage of transformers. So do you see, will you do research? Because I've done, if you go to the Western world, you do not see any transformer, and I know you've been there. So you do not see transformers there. Do you think we can have KPLC having a company where it will be having fiber optic? I know they are doing it right now, but because of the ICT of this government, to deliver fiber optic to each and every place, because it's a vast network, as you have spoken about it. The last one is about the Kenya pipeline refinery. Your predecessor, if you are confirmed, who was here, Davis Chirchir, he said they were looking at it once the oil, which Honorable Posing has talked about, the Tolo oil and all that, once it's done. But I believe if that refinery was there, we could even get cheaper fuel and refine it the way it used to be. So do you think it is possible under your watch if you are confirmed? Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Honorable.
You can answer those.
Honorable Speaker. Yes, indeed it is true. That is, with respect to Honorable Mbui's question, that members of parliament are facing serious pressure from the public on the matter of last mile connectivity in their respective constituencies. Because again, it has been taken for granted that this is the work of the MPs, okay? Which they have been doing, of course, very diligently in collaboration with the RERC. Honorable Speaker, what we need to do, in my view, is to properly resource RERC. Properly resource RERC as we work on the efficiencies for this rural electrification to be fast-tracked. As we speak, the data I have is that we are at about 76% penetration. That, of course, is theoretical, because you know in some areas it's as low as 10%, while in others it is over 100%. Yes. So I'm very much alive to that fact. In fact, we need also to bring on board counties, county governments. Honorable Speaker, under Schedule 4 of the Constitution, the counties have a role also in energy, more so in street light. Okay? What has happened in the past is that REREC has been able to build street lights, which street lights go off soon after they are commissioned for lack of payment of bills and maintenance, which they presume is the mandate of the counties, Honorable Speaker. So my view, this set of affairs is not tenable. We must make a decision, and I'll be coming back to Parliament. Okay? We must make a decision as to whether to empower REREC fully, to be able to be in charge of this street lighting, up to including payment of bills. But more importantly, if we can now move away from the grid, national grid, and establish solar street lights, okay, which would be easy to manage in the long term. That's a discussion we must have urgently, because these are important facilities. Honorable Speaker, on the matter of public confidence, as raised by Honorable Mbui, you know, Honorable Speaker, I am very clear in my mind, extremely clear, because I've been on this space for quite some time. The Gen Zs, or the youth, were not raising any different issues from the issues you and I, Honorable Mbui, have raised over the years. They could have had a different style, okay? But the issues they were raising were pertinent issues, which you all agree must be dealt with, okay? And therefore, it is not proper to say that we have taken advantage of the Gen Z's clamor to get into government. First and foremost, Honorable Speaker, I never applied to join the executive, but I was pleasantly surprised and felt greatly honored that my name was recommended. His Excellency the President went ahead to nominate me.
You know the facts. Just answer the questions.
So, Honorable Speaker, I still maintain the view that we are not in any way in betrayal of the
court. Don't allow Mbui to bully you.
Of the youth, yes.
And have no apologies.
Yes. Yes. But again, Honorable Speaker, as I conclude on that one, you know, we are basically coming on board in a paradigm shift. I'm very pleased that the President has actually declared that we have to adopt a paradigm shift in the management of government and state affairs. And I'm most privileged if I'm
approved. In our country. Yes.
Yes. Thank you, Honorable Speaker. We are living in different times. Yes. Yes, so we must also think differently. Sorry. Honorable Speaker, Honorable Baya, you are right. The cost of power is exorbitant in Kenya. Even if you compare ourselves to our neighboring countries, especially Ethiopia and even Uganda, really. But part of the reason why our cost of power is too high, is the exorbitant amount of commercial and technical losses that Kenya Power, especially in cars. Kenya Power loses up to 23% of the power it buys from the generators. Okay? In other words, doesn't sell almost 23% of the power it buys from the generators.
Inefficiency and recklessness.
Yes, there are many factors.
You must assure the country that this will stop.
This is going to be managed. I can't say it will stop, Honorable Speaker, because in any scientific process, there can be losses, but they have to be reasonable losses, Honorable Speaker. Yes. So we are going to work closely with the KPLC, and I'm happy, Honorable Speaker, by the work the KPLC management is doing currently. As a matter of fact, I'm privy to the information that they have done some turnaround. I'm not allowed by the rules of the CMA to get into details, but they have done some turnaround, and they may post some good figures in the coming...
Don't be prejudiced by briefs you have received. You'll get there and learn.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. I'm just being optimistic.
Yes.
And giving the country hope. to borrow your words.
Yes. Okay. Continue.
Honorable Speaker, let me dash to the question, sorry, by Honorable Daoud. Murugaara.
Murugaara first.
Murugaara, yes. Honorable Speaker, it is true there have been historical injustices. Okay? And we must work together in terms of addressing these injustices or these imbalances. We must correct them systematically. But I must also throw a challenge to my colleagues in the National Assembly, because I'm aware that this lopsided allocation of resources, especially on energy and electricity, is also coming from us in Parliament at the budget time. The agencies, the ministries, are receiving printed estimates with figures which they cannot change, they can't touch. Which figures are scary, Honorable Speaker? You find one constituency being allocated upwards of 400 million Kenya shillings, while another one is getting a paltry 10 million Kenya shillings in the same financial year. So we must also actually do some introspection as a house to help us in the ministry, if and when I am approved, to deal with this issue. No, once you bring printed estimates, the ministry, the agencies have got no leg room. They have no room to maneuver. Okay? So these imbalances, these injustices may continue within, as we watch, Honorable Speaker. There is also the issue of solars for schools. There is currently a very robust project being undertaken by REREC, the solar for schools. We want to follow through this project to ensure that at least every school in this country is able to benefit.
Point of order. No. Point of order.
George?
Point of order. Solar has been tried from time immemorial. It works only for 1 month, 2 months. It just dies. And those schools will remain in the books of KPLC or whoever that they are connected through solar when actually it is not working. So it doesn't make sense whatsoever for Kenya Power or for RELEC to introduce or to go back to that solar business. Let us get connection to the national grid so that we also assured of constant electricity supply.
Point of order, Chairman, on the same.
Yes.
And you know, this was done mostly from the regions I come from. It is so that if you do electricity, the households around the school also are connected to power. But now if you give us solars, you're just giving to the schools, they're vandalized, they're not working, and you continue to marginalize us on issues to do with electricity. We don't want the solars.
Point of order,
it is vendor driven, the solars.
Yeah, point of order, Chair. I just want to urge my colleagues that, you know, the nominee is actually a nominee. And we are addressing the nominee like the CS for energy, a decision
which
we are yet
is
to
not
make. Because the pressure is on him now dealing with solar versus you know, regular energy. So
no, it's important for him to know.
We are working on the probabilities.
You are being warned of landmines ahead.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
I've taken note. Yeah. I've taken note, Honorable Speaker. Let me just proceed quickly to Honorable Daoud. Yes, I've gotten your point on the possibility of moving from oil-based transformers to something else. I need to check with the technical people to be able to give some feedback on that. Honorable Speaker, there's an issue raised, the Honorable Daoud raised, on the Kenya oil refinery. Did you mean refinery or the Kenya pipeline?
Oil refinery with the pipeline.
Yes. You know, I am aware that the Kenya oil refinery has or is in the process of being acquired by the Kenya Pipeline Company. I will need to get into the details as to the rationale behind this, but I still foresee a very big role for the Kenya oil refinery, at least its installation. Firstly, in terms of the processing of the crude oil, if and when it finally flows from the South Lokichar, yes, to Mombasa, But more importantly, Honorable Speaker, I have come to the realization that this country does not have provision for a strategic reserve of oil. That we can actually one of these days wake up and find that we can't bring oil to Mombasa. And then after some few days or weeks, we are ground to a halt as a country. So I think this facility in Mombasa will can still be useful in future. Once and when, once we work on the strategic oil for the country that can last for at least 90 days, that's the best practice universally, Honorable Speaker. Thank you.
You have not answered if KPLC can do the fiber accompany. Would yes. it be possible or not?
I will also pursue this. Yes.
Mary, Emase.
Thank you. Nominee, you've talked about customer satisfaction. I put it to you that KPLC customers are the most dissatisfied. And I want to believe that there are serious management challenges to do with the leadership of KPLC. Why do I say that? A simple task, but of urgent nature, like restoring a falling post or a collapsing post, because a time bomb, it can collapse any time, it posing danger, and in certain instances it has occasioned deaths. It will take forever before it is restored. Actually, there is one about to fall onto my house. You will call so-called regional directors. There is no response. Secondly, restoring power when there are those frequent outages. A transformer has failed or has busted, and some of them are in learning institutions in our regions. It is adversely affecting learning. In my constituency, some of them have taken more than 6 months, and it's not only in my constituency, it cuts across the country. If you are actually approved, you tell us what you're going to do about some of these management issues. Meter acquisition, you have applied for meters. And I'm told even these meters are already being adulterated by the cartels in the industry. You will wait forever. Kenyans have to bribe to get meters. Now, knowing the Wandai that we know, I want to believe you're going to fight corruption in the energy sector. Sometimes, villagers have had to come together in this achama for power so that they put money together to procure an independent electrician to restore power. This is the Kenya we are living in, Honorable Wandai. And finally, you've talked about making sure that all the power lines, the projects that are incomplete or ongoing, that you will make sure they are completed in the shortest time possible. And I'm asking myself, Honorable Wandai, where are you going to get the money from? Because after rationalization of the budget and the collapse of the finance bill, which you strongly objected to reject the bill, can you tell us where are you going to get resources to finance all those projects? Because I want to believe the reason they are incomplete is because of funding. Thank you.
Thank you, Honorable Speaker. Nominee, there are some key transmission lines that are yet to be constructed. And with the shrinking revenue and reduced headroom to borrow, what are you going to do to ensure that they are done since the country needs them?
Honorable Mishimbo.
Yeah, thank you, Honorable Chairman. Honorable Chairman, my first question is on environmental concerns. And I'm talking about the proposed Lamu coal power plants. I know there have been some opposition from environmental groups concerned about the impact on the local ecosystem. So my question is, how will you balance energy needs with environmental protection? My second question, it is on the issue of the project that the Lake Turkana Wind Power Project. I know you are once the chair of PAC, and I was also in the committee of PAC. And this matter kept on coming and coming each and every time. This project was at a tune of 70 billion, and so many billions had been already utilized. So I just want to ask you, do you see that the taxpayers' money had some value to where we are right now in regards to that Lake Turkana wind? I know you are not yet the minister for that energy. Maybe you're going to be approved. I want you to check on this, because a lot of money have really been utilized, and yet we don't see any tangible results from that. My last question, it is in reference on what happened in Embakasi on the 2nd of February, where there was the explosion, and so many Kenyans were killed and some were injured. Again, there was an explosion by the petroleum tanker in Sashangwani about 11 years back, the other one at Molo. So my concern is, what safe standard measures are you going to put in place to ensure that we save Kenyans from such fatal accidents and any other times? I thank you, Honorable Chairman.
Sharia. Sure.